It is another round of zonal intervention projects of members of the National Assembly, and this time, Honorable Representing Irepodun Olorunda Orolu Osogbo Federal Constituency, Honorable Olubukola Oyewo, has chosen to place his constituents again through empowerment, training, and funding. This time, it is market women across the four local government areas of the federal constituency. 200 women were gathered for a 3-day strategic training and empowerment of market women on cooperative groups.
Ododo lowo igba erun lo nso onilo ibomire so towo ba wa lowo ta ba toju e owo a ma lo a ma fini sile o ta n gbiyanju ati so ni pe eni to ba fe se oloko owo gidi o nilo lati make sure pe ohun manage oro to Olorun fun.
The program, executed by Federal Cooperative College, Ibadan, spanned for 3 days, from Monday to Wednesday, November 8th to 10th, 2021. On Monday, participants were executives of market associations across the constituency. They were trained on how to organize and coordinate cooperative groups within their markets, with emphasis on the importance of the groups. Tuesday was purely devoted to training of 200 participants, and the grand finale was aired on Wednesday. Present at the grand finale of the program were the Osun State Commissioner for Women and Children Affairs, Olubukola Olabokpo, Special Advisor to Governor Gboyega Oyetola on Political Affairs, Honorable Sunday Akiri, his colleagues in the Ministry of Trade and Investment, Sola Ogunfolaju Oyehan, among others. The hall encouraged beneficiaries at the program to maximize the knowledge acquired during the training. They also used the avenue to campaign for the second term ambition of Governor Gboyega Oyetola.
First of all, we must congratulate the organizer of this program, Honorable Bukola Oyewo, and also those people that benefited from the program. The government at the state level alone cannot do everything. That is why it is imperative on our representatives, both at the State Assembly and National Assembly, to come back and support the government in ensuring that the dividend of democracy gets to the grassroots. The beneficiaries of this one definitely is going to enhance and boost their trade. And the advice I have is that whoever benefited should not make it the end. They should ensure that they stick to the conditions and the rules given by the people that provided the grants so that others too can benefit.
There is no two routes to eradicating poverty anywhere in the world other than to ensure that appropriate persons get empowered. This that Honorable Bukoy has brought to his federal constituency is very laudable. It will ensure that our women who are not empowered get empowered, and that some of them who are already empowered invest more into their businesses. And I'm sure, going by records, I know that Osun women are very industrious and prudent. They will make good use of the opportunity.
Akiri and Olabokpo call on the women to continue supporting Oyewo in his bid to transform the constituency, and also be ready to vote Governor Gboyega Oyetola in 2022 governorship election in the state, stating that this will bring more dividends of democracy to their doorsteps.
In everything, our women are always at the forefront. If you go to the church, they are always in the larger number. If you go to the mosque, if you go to even the markets, any political gathering or even election, the women are always number one. Our message is that they should support Alhaji Gboyega Oyetola in ensuring that the dividends of democracy which you have been enjoying in Osun in the past 3 years continues. If anybody is now coming around now to say that they want to be sharing food at the markets, they should know that all these are just gimmicks meant to steal their vote, to steal their conscience ahead of the election. They should realize that the government of Alhaji Gboyega Oyetola have been doing this good thing in the past 3 years, and it's going to continue doing it. We should all support him and ensure that good governance continues in the state of Osun.
My message to our women is to keep supporting Mr. Governor. There is no doubt that Osun women are solidly behind him. They are rooting for him. They are working for him. And I have no doubt that when it comes to election, they will come out en masse, you know, out of conviction, without force, to cast their vote for Mr. Governor.
Addressing participants, representative of Ataoja of Osogbo at the event and Babaloja of Sasha Market, Chief Kamoru Yusuf Efe, described the program as a laudable, commending the lawmaker for fulfilling his electoral promises.
Eto ti Mukola Oyewo nse loni eto to da ni nitori pe igba to nse ipolongo ibo in lo ti se ileri kaakiri gogo awon ijoba bile ti o wa bi pe ti on ba debe o ma se dada a gloruko abawa to ja wa ri bi pe bo se ndebe yi se onarebu ti kan joko kale Labuja. Gbogbo awon eto to ye ki o to si pinle Osun o na lo ngbiyanju to n ko wa sile to ba de ti ko dile na lo n pe gbo awon oba ori ade pe mo ti ko awon nkan ti o mu ipinle Osun dagba soke ni joba ibile ti won yan mi side o si n se awon eto o ti n se awon ona lai moye ti gbogbo awon ijoba ibile mere ni ti o wa ni abe re ko si koyan gbogbo awon loba loba ko koyan wa kere bi a se ni ipenija eto oro aje ni orilede yi ti awon obirin wa si gbiyanju pelu owo ti en fun won e ti o tun wa se yi o ti mudunun ba gbogbo oja ti o wa ni ijoba ibile ti a ti dibo fun to yi we ba wo bo le loni gbogbo nu awon iyaloja wa ti ndun bi pe oko awon oko owo won yo tun lekun si tori pe inu ayo lo wa a si ti ba gbogbo awon to wa ninu oja na soro pe ti en ba ti nje anfani o ti en ba ti nda pada awon oloja to ku na ki won tun ma ku awon eyan mara ki owo yi o fi kaakiri awon yoku.
In his address, Olubukola Oyewo said his major priority is to eradicate poverty in his constituency through empowerment and training of individuals. One of his aides, Okpoyemi Oladimeji, urged the beneficiary to maximize the loans given to them. He said more of such programs are coming their ways. Some of the participants who spoke with Inside Links TV showered their praises on the lawmaker, describing him as a man of his word.
A dupe lowo honorable Bukoy fun ise takutaku ti won se a de dupe lowo gomina wa Oyetola fun ajosepo won to dan moran Olorun Elejumare ko ni da ipinle Osun ati orilede Nigeria ri a de tun dupe tori ati bi ijeta lati wa lenu program yi gbogbo e lo nlo leto leto ba won ko wa bi a se lo lowo wa awa ti ati lowo bi o tun se ma po si opopolopo awon eyan wa mi akan taja ni. Elomi so pe awon o le sise mo won je ka mo pe ni tension ba da ni a ma ntun gun ni so a dupe pupo
o se gudugudu meje yaya fun awo be tori fun kini teyan ba wa laye to ba je to ni ke lomi ori je adua na loro re ba ko mo lo oke si ni lagbara olohun ko ni re lule ko ti ni pade akoba
a dupe lowo gomina wa ipinle Osun o a ti dupe lowo Bukoy oloke loke o koni sele kan mo opolopo ni o se ajupe lo gomina Oyetola to je ko wo Oyetola si a o opolopo ni ti se ti wo ka wa ye asi dupe pon ka wa si ye si ka yo ku na ran ti wa o opo odun la se laye o 4 plus 4 is equal to 8.
Representative of the consulting company Stella Ogene speaks on the importance of the training to the women.
Was like on the first day we had training session for the market executives, the executives of each market group. They were the first to be trained because we believe that the bulk of the knowledge they will also be able to transmit to their members from level to level. Our facilitators do the thing. They were also from this part of the country. They were all Yoruba men, so they were able to break down the complex principles, complex knowledge, bring it down to their level, speak to them in the language that they understood, and they were able to get it. Because in the sessions we had practicals, in the sessions there were questions and answers, answer sessions, to ensure that they grasped what they were learning. This cooperative society is geared towards establishing and developing a savings culture. Okay, they are market women, and we know that the economy today is somehow, we are looking at ways where we can bring out sources of income without necessarily depending on the government. This is a time that we are encouraged, you know, to do things by ourselves, to kind of like take our future in our own hands. So for distance now, the issue here is investment, okay? They are to learn how not to eat everything that they make, but that they should plow back some resources from their earnings into savings. And that's number one. Number two, they have to establish a good sense of checks and balances. The people that they are going to be involved in handling their money, they should be well vetted. You understand? Teach them about fraudulent practices. These are part of the things that they learned, you know, during the course of the program.
From Oshogbo, Jare Tiamiyu, Inside Links TV.